Shattenkirk a little slow to get up after a collision. And Mikhail Maltsev, and we've got a fight.
No surprise here.
This is the fifth time MacDermid and Deslauriers have dropped the gloves over their careers. MacDermid only his second shift, and he finds his old dancing partner, Nicolas Deslauriers.
Yeah, MacDermid, 6'5", 223 pounds.
This is the heavyweight matchup. Deslauriers and MacDermid. Linesman watching from a distance for now. These aren't soft punches either. Couple of big rights there from Deslauriers.
Buckets off right there.
They're not done yet.
Nope. Pushing the linesman aside. He wants to continue on here. Well, here goes the elbow pad on MacDermid.
Trying to get inside, just a wild roundhouse. And a marathon bout between MacDermid and Deslauriers, and they're still going.
Holy jumping.
MacDermid with a late round comeback here.
Deslauriers doesn't have much in the tank, unless he's playing a little rope-a-dope at the end. That's a big time scrap right there. MacDermid comes to the defense of Kevin Shattenkirk. Deslauriers comes to the defense. Boy, that's a good scrap right there. Good scrap.
Kurtis MacDermid, 7 of his 18 career fights have been against Anaheim. That's the fifth time he's fought Nick Deslauriers.
Yeah, the veteran Kevin Shattenkirk was the one that, you know, MacDermid goes by as Shattenkirk has the puck, pops up with the hit, and there's... he basically runs right into his arm. I don't think MacDermid did anything out of the ordinary right there other than be really, really big and like a brick wall. And Shattenkirk was worried about the backside pressure, so he didn't actually see Big 56. But, you know, in the course of the game, Deslauriers thinks that something else happened. He knows that his veteran, popular player in Shattenkirk's down. He's going to step right up there. And as you mentioned before, I mean, before the game, he said, you know, they have fought four times before. And this is now the fifth time that they've gone head-to-head with MacDermid. The decided edge in height and weight.
Second time this season they dropped the gloves. Deslauriers fired up. I mean, you just don't see that anymore.
And you can see Deslauriers just before he went to the box. He was yelling to the crowd, trying to get them fired up.
Imagine the adrenaline that you got after a scrap like that. Imagine how exhausted you are. And then you got to look at your mitts and say, okay, what got caught up? And then you got to look at your face, okay, where am I at right here? And you know, there's some experienced mitts right there. Like,
blood on top of their faces.
Wait, I think they're saying good scrap. Is that right?
Definitely, yeah. Yes.